It's Weekend Update with Colin Jost and Michael Che.
Good evening, everyone.
Welcome to Weekend Update. I am Michael Che.
I'm Colin Jost, and here are tonight's top stories. Tonight's GOP debate just ended in South Carolina, and Donald Trump was repeatedly booed throughout the evening. Here's a quick clip of Trump responding to Jeb Bush.
Jeb is so wrong. Jeb is absolutely so.
And the crazy thing is, all Jeb said was, "It's great to be here in South Carolina." Also, don't you guys know you can't boo Donald Trump? He doesn't hear boos. If you boo Donald Trump, in his head, it's just this.
Jeb is so wrong. Jeb is absolutely so.
At the Democratic debate, Hillary Clinton and Bernie Sanders both made concerted efforts to appeal to African-American voters, one a lot more than the other. At the end of that debate, Hillary pulled hot sauce out her bag. This week, Bernie Sanders met with the Reverend Al Sharpton at Sylvia's restaurant in Harlem. And let's just say they did not tip well.
During the Democratic debate, Hillary Clinton attacked Bernie Sanders, saying that he needs to be more honest with voters about the difficulty of accomplishing many of his proposals, while Clinton's critics say she has to be honest with voters about... all that stuff. And then there's all... oh, there's more. Oh, wow, okay. Gotta be honest about that stuff. Donald Trump promised this week that he will stop using profanity and other vulgar language on the campaign trail, saying, "As we get closer, you will be shocked at how presidential I'll be," adding, "You'll love it so much, you'll cream your jeans."
This week, Beyonce faced outrage for her controversial halftime performance, but also, no, she didn't. Can we just stop overusing the word outrage? When did outrage go from pitchforks and torches to strongly worded tweets? I mean, even if you were outraged, what are you really gonna do about it? What, stop listening to Beyonce? Impossible. She's too good. She's like the Beyonce of music. And the better you are at something, the more you can get away with. You know, not long ago, there was an actual petition to kick Justin Bieber out of the country just for being a horrible person. And then we heard that song, Sorry, and we were like, ah, you can stay, man. People got mad when Kanye tweeted Bill Cosby is innocent this week. But my first thought was, damn, Kanye's new album must be dope. And it is. When you're that dope, you can say whatever you want. My grandmother's the most prejudiced person I know, and we all ignore it. Why? Because she's the Beyonce of sweet potato pie.
This month, NBC will air a special that features a reunion of the cast of Friends. Here to comment is Rachel from Friends. Oh my God, this is incredible. You know, it's so great to see you, Rachel.
Oh, Colin! Oh, hi! Hi! Oh! Wow! Yeah!
You know, Rachel, I gotta say, I haven't seen you since the 90s, probably. How you been?
What? Oh, I've been good. Yeah.
Good. So, are you excited to see all your friends again?
Oh, yeah, you know, Joey, Chandler, Phoebes, Mon, and of course, you know, Ross. Yeah,
that's all of them.
You know, I'm seeing them tonight. Yeah, Phoebes is playing a show at Central Perk, and then we're all gonna jump in the fountain with umbrellas.
Oh,
yeah. Nice. Oh, you know, you should come. Oh, I'll see you there. Okay. Yeah. Okay. Bye.
I'm sorry. What just happened?
What? Oh, yeah. Yeah. You know. Yeah, that happens to me every few minutes. Yeah, it's weird. Yeah, I don't know, it's weird. Oh, speaking of which, hey, what's that?
What's what? Oh, that's Michael Che.
She's on Friends. She's never seen a black person come.
Oh, yeah. That makes sense.
Oh, yeah. Oh, hey, yeah. Oh, hey, why don't you both come over tonight? Phoebes, is going to bring her new boyfriend, and he's not going to fit in. I'll see you there. Yeah.
Wait. Yeah. Now you have a baby?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, sometimes. Yeah. Oh, take it.
Rachel, okay, is it me or do you always sound surprised by everything?
Oh, what? Oh, yeah. Wow. Okay. What? Yeah. Okay. What? Yeah. Huh? Oh,
Rachel from Friends, everyone.
Oh, yeah.
At a rally in Baton Rouge this week, Donald Trump signed the hand of a toddler. The message read sweetly and simply, deport me.
Just yesterday, Ted Cruz pulled a new campaign ad after it was revealed that a woman featured in the ad was a former softcore porn actress. And once you know she's a porn actress, the guy's entrance at the end of the ad is a lot more fun. Here it is.
Maybe you should vote for more than just a pretty face next time.
You guys have room for one more?
I'm beginning to think that started as a porno, and then they just ended up talking about Ted Cruz. I mean, listen to it again with the music turned up.
Maybe you should vote for more than just a pretty face next time.
You guys have room for one more?
I'm Ted Cruz, and I approve this
porno.
All seamless voiceover. U.S. officials say that the satellite North Korea launched into orbit is tumbling and incapable of functioning, earning it the nickname Marco Rubio.